want you to feel the burden lifting because you've been fighting your difference. Some of you have been hating your difference because it's been so hard to be you. It feels like there's attacks on every side. It feels like nobody understands what you're trying to say and what you're trying to do. And there have been many nights where you have cried yourself to sleep and you have prayed, God, just make me like everyone else. And because he loves you, he has not answered that prayer. Because he loves you. He loves you so much, he will allow you to remain different because he knows your difference will take you everywhere he's planned for you to be.
Good morning, guys. It is Saturday. It is a good day. I have a lot of little cool errands I'm going to run around for some creative work. But I just wanted to briefly talk about that message. You guys saw a little snippet of it from Devon Franklin. It's called Your Difference is Your Destiny. And I really recommend you guys taking a look at that. That was a really good video. And very empowering. I think it's really good that we take the time to evaluate ourselves from the perspective of God's point of view. And the video just talked about us being different was how God designed us. You know, we weren't meant to be like everybody else. And sometimes us trying to be like everybody else frustrates us because we want to fit in. We want to be accepted and loved. And, you know, in the message, it talks about that's not bad. It's normal. But to what extent, to what degree, you know, if we're hating who we are, we dislike who we are, we're mourning the fact that we are different and that we can't fit in or that things don't seem to go right or that we can't make ourselves be what we think we should be, whether it's being like someone else or being a societal standard or being, you know, in order to be a real blah, 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 fill in the blank, a real man, a real woman, a real African-American, a real whatever it is, whatever you put that to be. But God says, I have something different. I made you different. I need you to stand out. God desires to use us for specific things, for wonderful things, and we need to be able to embrace the wonderful things that he's done within us, the good works that he's done within us. We are sanctified as believers. That means we are set apart, made holy. That means that he has some special plans for us. That means that there is something in the world that he wants us to be a part of, that he wants us to take part of and fill and make better and help grow and nourish. And by being different, we can do that. But we need to embrace that difference. We need to be able to not only embrace it, but be bold. God tells us have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. You know, do not be trembled or dismayed. For the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. So we can't be afraid of who we are. You know, we have to be bold and courageous in these things. God also tells us that no man will ever be able to intimidate us all our lives, you know. And that means that with God, you know, doesn't mean that things won't scare us, but ultimately God will persevere. God will win. God will be victorious. And because we are in Christ, we too take part of that victory. And all that to say is, I watched the video, watch the video definitely, and embrace your differences, embrace the things that make you different, and learn how those are a great thing. Learn how that is a great thing to be different, and learn how to love that, and learn how to move in that, and learn how to be victorious because of that. And you will soon learn, as you are loving who God made you to be, the awesome path that he has for you. And how distinctly he's going to take you. Even if you also want to be a doctor, he will have you to be a doctor in a different way. Even if you also want to be an artist, he will help you to be an artist in a different way. And you will be victorious. You will be successful in the way that he has planned. And you will know that it is for you. You will feel peace. You will feel loved. You will feel like you are walking in your purpose because you are not compromising who you are, but you are accepting who Christ made you to be. Amen. Amen. All right. My arm is getting tired and I'm hungry. So I'm going to go make up this bed because it's kind of messy. And then I'm going to go make breakfast. See you in a bit.
You guys like my onesie? These don't come with it. That's just my slippers, but it's so comfortable. I got this like, oh man, I almost want to say 4 years ago, maybe. My mom gave this to me my junior year when I was in college, and I've graduated about 2 years ago. So yeah, about 4 years. But isn't it cool? It's so comfortable. It's from One Piece. I will put a link in the description down below so you guys can like take a look at them. But this is so comfortable. It's so, and I don't care that's like kind of like Christmassy theme. Like even when it's not Christmas, I'm still gonna wear this in the cold months. So yeah, super comfortable. It's got pockets here, it's got pockets here. For guys, you know, because this is unisex, you know, if you gotta go to the bathroom, easy access. It's not really any use for me, but it's good, you know, that it's a long zipper. So it's really cool, and the hoodie's great. It zips all the way up. So I don't even know if you got that because I was like doing that, but anyways, really cool. Oops, you only see that. You only see that? Anyways, peace out. Let me go make breakfast now before I make any more of a mess. Bye. Just trying to like see if I could do it. Pretty good, not as good as the restaurant. So I'll have to tweak some things. But anyways, I have some things I have to do today. So I'm going to wash my face, do my makeup, do my hair, all that good stuff, and get ready. So
this is moving way too fast.
If you're a fan of Nicholas Sparks movies, you'll love Forever My Girl.
Forever.
You already know the vibes I get when I go to the thrift store. It still has the short pads in. Oh, and it still has a tag. So this one was, oh, you can't really see it, but that says $3.49, and it was half off. So $1.75 for this really cool tag.
Just real quick, I just want to say, y'all, I was having like such bad skin problems earlier this year. I think it's an allergic reaction to my paint. Unfortunately, my paint of choice is acrylic. But I think I might have an allergic reaction to it. I don't know. Maybe not. It could have just been hormones, whatever. But I have a really bad skin reaction. But my skin's become is getting better. It's glowing, you know. It's like more even. There's still some dark spots, but like that's okay. They're definitely fading and they're getting better. So I've been doing like a new routine and stuff to like get that settled in. But yeah, you like my slick hair? I actually really like my slick. I'm actually going to do something different. I'm going to put a pony on the back. My hair, by the way, it's put in a bun, but I was so excited yesterday and this morning. Like, my hair is actually really long. Like, I actually have a legit, not like a little stub that's like, oh, here's my ponytail. No, like, I actually have a legit pony. Let me see. I'll take it out a little bit. It's in braids, so it's even shorter. If you can imagine, but like, imagine if it wasn't braided up, right? That's like a legit ponytail, you know? So I'm super excited, but I wanted to try something different. So I'm going to put a pony on, cause you know, I like changing it up. So I'm gonna put a pony on it as well. So I'm gonna play with that. But yeah, I actually really like, I would even go out just like this. Like, I like my hair slick back, and I haven't done this in a while, but I really like it. I really like it. But, anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and do my makeup and all that. So, this isn't going to be a talk through. I'm literally going to, cause I have stuff I got to do today. So I'm going to watch my YouTube, you know, and do my makeup and just enjoy. This is kind of like my enjoyment time. So I'm going to do that. And then, I have some things I got to get done today. Yo, this is actually really good. Like, I sighed because, you know, everyone always claims, as far as like different makeup brands, they claim like, you know, this makes your skin feel like your skin. This one actually, of all the ones I've tried, makes my skin feel like my skin, and it matches well. It's very, very, when it says weightless, this is the first time I can actually honestly say that this is weightless. Like, I don't feel like I'm wearing foundation when I have this on. I can't really say that with other ones. Not to say that they're not good, but this one is good and weightless. This might be my new, like, this one may be the one I always get now from now on. So, hey, Urban Decay, I'm down for this. I'm down for
this. Oh, so bad inside. Much better, so much better, baby.
Puerto Rican. If I could fake an accent, I would try, but I can't. But yeah, this is the look, and I feel cute. So now I'm going to go out. I'm going to go to my studio. I'm also going to go by, there's this clothing store that's just up the street from the studio, and I know the guys there, and I'm looking for a denim jacket because I have a really cool project that I want to do with the denim jacket, and they find like vintage or like stuff from like thrift stores and they bring into their store, and so I'm gonna go there as well, and then after that I'm probably gonna stop by a couple of stores to get like little accessories, things to like embellish the jacket as well as the bag that I want to go corresponding with it. So I'm gonna go ahead and go, and I'll take you guys with me. See you on the road. Right guys, I'm in the car, I'm about to head out. About to go do some things. And I'm not going to drive and vlog because I'm not crazy. I want to live. I have so many things I want to do in life. So you'll just have to see me when I get there, y'all. So peace out. Guys, I'm sorry. I'm such a bad vlogger. I already went to the studio and I already went to the store that I need to go to. But I have some other stores I need to go to. So I promise I'll be more diligent the rest of the day. But let me go ahead and show you kind of what I got. I'll probably do another post, another clip later, with it on. Oh man, I can't believe I didn't. I mean, I'm still in front of the store, but I don't really want to go back in, even though it wouldn't be a big deal. But let me show you real quick what I got. I got this denim jacket. I have something really cool that I'm going to do with it. I'll have to take a post of it later when I'm wearing it, because right now with it on, like it doesn't show very well, but it's really cool. It has like four or five pockets in the front. And I got it from these guys who actually used to work at the studio, or were artists at the studio that I am now at. And now they have their own shop and they sell vintage, like kind of throwback clothes. They go thrifting, they go to flea markets, and they bring their stuff here. They're good finds, and they have their own store here. So let me show you real quick. This is them, the Vaulty. Yeah, really cool guys. And they have some pretty cool stuff in there. And I think it's just good to be able to work and connect with different artists. So I told them, like, hey, do you have any denim jackets? And they were like, yeah, come on by. So I'm very happy. I'm very happy with this purchase. And it was for a very good price. They actually, you know, gave me a discount just, you know, to help me out a little bit. So that was really awesome. And they were really great for that. So thank you guys so much. I'm about to head out to, I think I'm gonna go ahead and go to Hobby Lobby. I'm trying to think if I want to go to Joann's Fabrics or not. I know Hobby Lobby has fabrics, so maybe I'll just go there, because that's more on my way home than stopping by Joann's. I think, I don't know. I'll decide. Well, I'll figure it out. Whenever I get to wherever I'm gonna go, then I'm gonna take you guys out again, okay? See you in a bit. Peace. I really love my look today. I feel all types of cute. Sometimes you gotta celebrate a little bit, you know, like, ooh, feeling all types of cute. I'm happy to say that my actual ponytail is like this, where my hand, the top of my hand's like this long. So just give me a couple more years, guys, and this could all be real. This could all be mine. All right, guys, I'll see you in a bit. All right, y'all. We're finally at the last store. We're at Hobby Lobby. I decided this is where I'm gonna go. I'm just gonna look around, see if I find anything. I have an idea already of like what I'm doing, but I'm just going to go look to see if there's anything there I like. I don't know if I'll necessarily buy today, because I'm trying to be a little bit more wise about my spending. I think one day when I have just like, you know, just consistent income coming in, then I can probably just pick up things I like and just like, you know, have them in storage. But I have to be a little bit more selective now with just like what I pick up. Like if I pick it up, I have to definitely be using it. So I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna go take a look and see what I can find. So yeah, let's go. I know I said I wasn't going to buy anything, but this fur, I actually was specifically looking for fur, which is why I'm in like the fabric section. But this is really nice, and it kind of goes with what I'm looking for, so I might actually pick this up today. We'll see. This is like shorter fur, but this is the one I really like. I don't know, guys, I might be getting it. It's a small part of it. Ooh, this was the other one I was thinking. I was actually thinking of this fur, but then I saw that one. Ooh, this like shearing. Oh my gosh. This just became tougher. It's gonna be between these two. I might get both. Alright guys, I'm back in the car. This is the only thing I got. Because I wasn't sure. This is my dilemma with the fur, right? I want to do a fur jacket. Like, I think that would be so cool. But this is my dilemma. Would you buy it? Not, I know you would buy a fur jacket, but this is the thing. Like, we're in January still. We're in mid-January. A little, almost towards the end of January. February is another cold month. And then March comes along. And I feel like there's not really enough time to be sporting a fur jacket, a fur coat, even though it would be just like the collar. So my thing is, would that be worth investing time in making? Because, you know, we're going to be heading into spring soon and all that. So part of me is thinking like, as much as I really want to do a fur jacket, that it might be kind of pointless at this point. I don't know. I really still want to do one because I want to wear one. I do not know. I have more than one jacket. I have two for sure. If I really want to, I could sacrifice my black leather jacket and I could do some stuff to that, but I don't know if I want to do that because that's my good, that's my only, oh my god, a little, my only good leather jacket at the moment. Man, I don't know. It's a tough call. You know what I would love? Like this bag right here, you see this color of this bag? I would love a leather jacket in that color. I would totally get that long fur. I would totally do something with that. So I'm going to go home now, going to eat something because I'm so hungry. And I'm going to figure out some designs for that. For that denim jacket back there. And I'll also show you a clip of what it looks like on so you can see. It fits long. It fits really cute. Like I feel like you could wear leggings with it. You could wear a skirt with it because it's pretty long. So, but anyways, I'm going to go ahead and go home and take care of that. So, I'll see you in a bit. Peace out.
Okay, guys, so this is the jacket. As you can see, it's fairly long. It's a good, decent size. You know what's funny? It's almost like, I almost think of it as a shirt, but it's not. But it's really cool. So you see it has like one huge pocket here, another one here, small one up here, and then one up here with a button. And then there's the back. It's a lot of room for me to do some cool stuff on. Look at that. So, I kind of lost my train of thought. So I have some plans. I have something that I do want to do with this. I have some stuff that I do want to do with this. So I'm going to just do some sketching. I may not get to it tonight. I'm going to probably do some like just brainstorming, some like thumbnail stuff, but probably won't be as extensive as I would like to today just because I have some other things I would kind of like to do. And also it's about that time to just chill with family and wind down. So I got plenty of time. I'll probably work on it all day tomorrow. Or at least a good chunk of the day tomorrow. So, yeah, so that might be it for today. But I really like it. I think it's going to be really fun. I'm not going to tell you guys what the idea is until I actually have it, like, fully thought out and sketched out. I know the concept, I just don't know the design, is what I mean. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this little quick vlog. I don't know if it's going to end here. I'll probably pop in later, maybe this evening, to give some like final words, some encouragement, because I think that's how I want to end every vlog if I can, with some words of encouragement, something that I've been thinking about, or something like that to lift you guys, you know? So, so we'll see. So if I don't see you later, see you till next week, and I'll see you around. Bye. Hello, beautiful people. I am now cleaned up. Phone's about to die. I'm gonna have to put this away soon. I don't really know what to say. I kind of want to leave you guys with something encouraging. Let me see. Give me a minute. Let me think. Hey, I don't like this angle.
Hold on. We got to get this right. Here we go. That's better.
Okay.
I want to leave you guys with a little something. I guess I'll just kind of talk a little bit again about the video that I watched earlier with Devon Franklin about your destinies and your difference, or the differences in your destiny, something like that. I think it's important that we embrace these things that make us different. I think we don't know where these things that we think are little quirks or things that we may wish that we didn't have, or we weren't so interested in, or we were more interested in something else. We don't know if that has something to do with our destiny. It can't be by accident. It can't be. If it's something that comes so natural to you, if it's something that you love to do, there's no way that it could be just an accident. Or something that you're really good at, but you wish you were good at something else. Why not invest more in the thing that you're naturally really good at? Or, you know, even just take the time to ask God, God, what do you want me to do with my life? Just embrace the things that are unique about you. If you like to change your hair, if you like to wear certain clothes, explore that. And you don't have to be in an agitated, angry way, being like, well, if you don't like it, then, you know, bye. You don't have to do all that. Just be who you are and live it out and be radiant. Let people say what they want and just live out and be happy with it. That's the biggest slap in the face. You don't have to actually like get up in their face to let them know that, you know, you don't care. Show you don't care by being happy with who you are. That's the thing. Show that you don't care by being happy and joyous with who you are. Live your best life. Be joyous. Be happy. Celebrate. You know, do the things that they're afraid to do, which is be themselves. You do that. You be yourself. You be who God made you to be. You rejoice and celebrate that. And when you do that, you know, you'll have more confidence to do other things that maybe God puts in your heart to do, because you're already becoming more confident in loving who you are, not in like an egotistical way, but in a way that says, you know what, no, God says this is me, you know what, dang it, I'm gonna be that person. I'm gonna love me, I'm gonna take care of me, I'm gonna explore more of the thing that I really want to do that. And don't worry about, you know, what if it doesn't lead me to a path of success, or what if it doesn't take care of me. Listen, if God gave you all these gifts, all these talents, all these little quirks or whatever, don't you think that he's going to take care of you? Why would he just leave you? We were meant to be different, because by being different, we stand out and we do things that other people don't do. We can't all be in the same job, or else other people out in the world don't get to see our light, don't get to see our joy. If you're a believer and you know, maybe your church or your family says, oh, you can't be doing that because it's too secular or whatever. There are some people who are in the secular world who are not going to come to church, but they're going to come to the movies if you're going to be an actor, right? Or they're going to come to a game if you want to be an athlete, or, you know, they're going to come to, an amusement park if you want to build amusement parks or work at whatever it is. All that to say is people need to see your light. They need to see your beauty. They need to see your strength, your wisdom, your courage, your boldness. People need to see that. And, you know, if you can just be bold enough in Christ, can just go out on a limb with God and just be like, God, you know what? By your strength, I'm going to be able to have the courage to do these things. I'm going to be able to have the courage to do the things you put on my heart to do. And you will find more peace and joy because you're not wrestling with trying to be something that you're not. And you will also find more happiness because you will be doing the things that God put on your heart to do and that you were meant to be doing. So whatever that is, whatever you feel you're meant to be doing or meant to be living out, or you're not living out your truth being that you're not living out who God made you to be, I would say take the time to pray about that. Take the time to look into that. Take the time to ask God, who am I? And then explore that. Or if you already know kind of what God's putting on your heart to do, ask him to help you see it the way you do it. Have the strength. One of my favorite verses, the verse of the week this week, that I have just been like coming, has been constantly coming to my mind, that I read on Monday, was be strong and courageous. Do not tremble or be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. So I pray this over you, that you will be strong and courageous this coming week, that you will not be fearful, that you will be able to embrace all that God is bringing into your life, and to not worry about whether or not who you are, whatnot, is going to, you know, prevent you from getting to where you want to go. God can get you to, if you want to be, for example, if you want to, you know, be an artist, but you feel like you have to be an artist the same way someone else is, just know that God can get you to be an artist in a way that's unique to you, and that's going to be true to you, and that is in a way that's going to inspire others because you're different from someone else. It is okay to get to the same place in a different way. There's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to do it the same way. That way, everyone can have a different story. We can't all be the same book. If we all had the same book, it would be boring, you know? But what makes life interesting is that there is variety. What makes great stories is that everybody's story is different. What makes, you know, awesome movies is that, you know, we have different characters, different plots, you know, even if there's similar themes. There's so many love movies out there. There's so many romantic films out there, but every plot's different. There's so many action movies out there, but every plot's different. There's a lot of superhero movies, but there's different superheroes. You can be different and you can be awesome. And so I just want you to be awesome and love who you are and see where God takes you, okay? I love you guys. Have an awesome week, and I will see you next week.